Well, there's a Holocaust going on in our midst. There's an abortion mill down the road on Roosevelt, the Anchor Abortion Mill. And the reason we're here is that when you need help, you go to a good man's house to ask for help. And because we don't go to bars to do this, we go to a church to do this because we assume that Christians who read the Bible would want to love their neighbors who are being taken away to death. And just like Christians ignored their murders who are neighbored in the Final Solution during Nazi Germany, and Christians are doing the same thing today. Children are being taken away to abortion mills to be murdered, and Christians, for the most part, are acting like it's no big deal, just like they did in Nazi Germany. And we're saying we need to have an urgency, because this is an emergency situation. And most Christians, they go about their business like it's just one of many issues, and they have no urgency at all. Mm-hmm. And for 4.5 decades, Christians have just like in the parable of the Good Samaritan, Christians for 4.5 decades have walked by like their religious leaders while their neighbors are being lying in the ditch being murdered. We have the same response. We look the other way while the killing goes on. And so we're just saying, please act like your neighbors are being murdered. And it's like, I was...
So what are you guys, like, is there a particular action point that you're wanting people to take at this point?
Well, one thing would be, there the Anchor Abortion Facility over, it's 1186 Roosevelt Road. Mm-hmm. I was there yesterday. Most people, there's only a few people out there yesterday. They murder children on Wednesdays and Saturdays. So I say, first, come out there on Wednesdays and Saturdays when mothers are going in to murder their children. And that'd be the first thing, and also to raise awareness about it, because a lot of people still have never seen these images. Uh-huh. And a lot of people, they don't talk about it, but like, talk about it with people, encourage others to go with you to the abortion mill, and hand out literature that exposes this Holocaust, you know. And like, the website's on here, Abolish Human Abortion. Mm-hmm. That, and also like looking it up on YouTube, that right there can give you ideas of what to do. Like for me, one thing I've done more of recently is go out to the streets. I go out to intersections and the public, and just anywhere in public where there's a lot of people, hold signs and give out literature to people and have conversations. Like that right there is a major thing that people can do. And like, well, we do that quite a bit. Like, you know, if you want to have others with you, then you could join us or, you know, whoever. But but I mean, those are some of the things that you can do. It, like another, giving out, one of the big things I do is I give out drop cards or literature everywhere I go. I just leave them behind in places like that. And just constantly confronting this culture of death. Because most Christians are comfortable not talking about this. And that's why it continues, is because it's not brought up very much. And most Christians don't even know there's an abortion mill in the area. I found that to be the case. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't even know there's an abortion mill down the road on Roosevelt. And that's why I talk about it a lot when I've been out here. And you go there on Wednesdays and Saturdays during the week, there'll be not many people out there. So it's like, we need Christians and the masses to go out there to the abortion mill, the local one, and to rescue those who are being taken away to death. And it will close down. What was your name?
Maria.
I'm Nicholas. Thank you, Maria, for talking with me.